With a career that extends for more than 60 years, Bill Anderson has written and co-written dozens of hits that have since become country standards, including Once a Day, The Lord Knows I'm Drinking, The Cold Hard Facts of Life, Saginaw, Michigan, City Lights, Tips of My Fingers, Whiskey Lullaby, and Give It Away. As a recording artist, he's charted over 80 singles in a period of 33 years, among them number one songs Still, Mama Sang a Song, I Get the Fever, My Life, Throw It Away If I Want To, and Sometimes, all of which he wrote. He was inducted into the Nashville Songwriters Hall of Fame in 1975, the Country Music Hall of Fame in 2001, and the Academy of Country Music Poets Award in 2007, and also induction into the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 2018. He is a country music legend, and he's got a brand new album, and he's here with us tonight to talk about it, and we're going to play some of this beautiful music for you. It is an honor and privilege to welcome Bill Anderson to My Kind of Country. Bill, it's great to have you on My Kind of Country tonight. How are you?
I'm doing well, Scott. How about you?
Just fantastic. Nice to talk to you again. I appreciate it very much.
Well, I'm talking to you from hot and humid Nashville, Tennessee.
All right. Well, I'm talking to you from hot and humid Traverse City, Michigan. So.
Yeah, but the difference is it cools off up there at night, and it doesn't cool off down here.
Yeah, amen to that. That's for sure. Well, you've got a brand new album out, The Hits Reimagined and Instrumentals. Make sure you go to BillAnderson.com. Bill, first of all, what was your inspiration for recording this album?
Desperation, I guess. I don't know. we're shut down here. We can't go in and record anything new, so let's release what we've got. No, I'm being silly there. The idea for this really it came about in a very unusual way, almost a backwards sort of way. Back in 2016, I was releasing a new autobiography and doing an audio book, and I was reading the audio book myself. And I was in the studio with a very talented engineer and record producer and musician named Tom Utes. And Tom had also done an audio book with Tom T. Hall. And he was telling me that on the Tom T. Hall audio book that he had played some little instrumental vignettes of some of Tom T.'s songs. And I said, well, why don't you do that on mine? In other words, when I'm talking about Whiskey Lullaby and how I wrote it for the audio book, why don't you play a little bit just on the guitar, just kind of a signature lick or two? And he got to doing that, and it sounded so good that I said, you know, we ought to make a whole album of instrumentals. So we started out this record by doing the instrumental versions of the songs. And I told him at the time, I said, record the instrumentals in the same key that I would sing them in case I might want to come along a little later and do vocals. And that's exactly what happened. So we got 10 vocals. We got 10 instrumentals. The songs are all well-known songs, going all the way back to the beginning of my career with City Lights and coming all the way up through Whiskey Lullaby and Give It Away. It's one of the most unique albums I've ever done. It's been a long time since anybody did any country instrumentals, and I'm finding that the people are enjoying it. The comments I've gotten so far have been extremely positive.
Well, that's great. Yeah, there used to be a lot of the bands, I know, like Merle Haggard, Strangers, and the Buckaroos, and a lot of the groups used to put out instrumental albums, the Texas Troubadours, and you really don't see that much anymore. So I think that's kind of a unique concept.
Well, you left out Bill Anderson's Po' Boys. We put out about a half a dozen albums during my days with Decca and MCA. But you're right, you just don't see those anymore. And these instrumentals are not fancy. They're very basic. They're very simple. They're acoustic. People are telling me that they enjoy them because they're kind of relaxing to listen to. I've had a few people say, you know, we're home with all this lockdown and the coronavirus stuff and not able to get out, and said, yeah, these instrumentals and this music kind of relaxes me, and I just kind of put it on as background music, which I think that's great. I'm just glad there's some use for it out there.
Well, you know, I sat with my headphones last night and listened to the entire album, and what I really like about it, Bill, is that you really can hear the essence of the lyrics, and the way you're singing them is there's so much emotion there, and it really comes out with the sparse instrumentation behind it. And I really love it's a listener's album. It really is. It's a very in-depth, and I love listening to every single word, and you can hear them so well.
Well, I appreciate that, Scott. Thank you. I naturally have kind of a soft voice anyway, and I always kind of wanted to record this way with just a little bit less instrumentation getting in the way, just kind of letting the lyrics stand out and the vocals stand out a little bit. Hopefully we've succeeded in that. I appreciate you telling me that very much.
Well, tell me about some of the musicians on this project.
Well, Tom Utes, who is a tremendous guitar player, he's credited with most of the instrumentation on here. He's playing the guitars, and at various places he plays a little dobro and a little banjo, I think. And he got together some really good musicians. Andrea Zahn, who's a terrific fiddle player, played with Vince Gill for years and has toured with just about everybody in the business. She's tremendous on the fiddle, and she plays some of the fiddle work on there. And then just various musicians. John Gardner does some of the drum work. There's not a lot of drum work on there.
No.
And
Who is the girl singing with you on Still? Boy, that was just beautiful.
Yeah, her name is Britt Savage. Yeah.
Well, it's beautiful. She does a beautiful job just laying those
she
harmonies.
She really does. I love the way she phrases it. She's kind of singing with me, and she's kind of singing about a half of a beat behind me, and it gives it a very unique flavor and a unique sound, and I really like what she did too.
Absolutely. Well, some heavy hitting songs on here, of course. Bright Lights and Country Music, Paul Folks is on here, City Lights, Still, Tips of My Fingers. Now, a technical question for you, and I'm going to go direct to the source here. I have seen this sang and printed two different ways, Tips of My Fingers and Tip of My Fingers. Which is the correct version?
Well, it depends on how many fingers you have. When I wrote it in 1960, all those years ago, I wrote it as the tip of my fingers. When Roy Clark came along and did it 3 years later, he did it as the tips of my fingers. When Eddie Arnold did it 3 years after that, he went back and did tip of my fingers. I actually think the tips of my fingers is probably grammatically correct.
Yeah, I noticed that's
I'm not totally sure, but for the last, 25, 30 years plus, I have sung it on stage and on records as Tips of My Fingers, and I think that's actually the way that I prefer it.
Yeah, I noticed you were singing it that way on this record, so we'll go with that. There's the official answer, folks. I love it. I love it. Well, Bill, you have really stayed relevant with your songwriting, even in current sounds of today, and I think that's very remarkable. And your songs are still being recorded by some of today's biggest artists, and you've included some of those songs on here, like Whiskey Lullaby, and A Lot of Things Different, and Which Bridge to Cross and Which Bridge to Burn, which is absolutely beautiful. I believe Vince Gill recorded that, right?
Yeah, Vince and I wrote that one together. I just got some really good news, speaking of that, and I appreciate your kind comments. Brad Paisley and I got together about 2 months ago on Zoom, with the cameras, where he's sitting at his computer and I'm sitting at mine, and we wrote a song together, and I just found out this past week that he plans to record it. So I'm still trying to get songs in the pipeline out there. Alan Jackson's holding a new song of mine that I'm hoping he's going to record. So I still get excited when people record my songs. I've been writing them and having them recorded for a whole lot of years, but the excitement never wears off. The thrill never wears off.
Absolutely. Well, it's nice to hear your versions of them too. Give It Away has been a favorite song of mine. When I first heard George Strait come out with it, I didn't know who wrote it. And then when I noticed it was you along with Jamie Johnson and Buddy Cannon, I thought, yep, that's a fantastic song right there. And you did a beautiful job on this one.
Thank you. Well, George had a great record on it. It's hard to beat his record. I wasn't trying to copy his record at all. We did it probably a little bit faster than he did it, and I hope the folks like the way that we recorded it.
Absolutely, and I'll Wait for You. That's another just beautiful song. Joe Nichols, was that the person that did that a few years ago?
Yeah, Joe had the big record on that. It's a song I wrote with Harley Allen, who was a tremendous songwriter, and I'm really proud of this song. This is one of two songs on the record that I've never recorded before, because I had recorded Bright Lights and Bo Folks and all the others that you mentioned, but I had never recorded I'll Wait for You, and I had never recorded Which Bridge to Cross. So there are two on here that the people have never heard me do before.
So that kind of brings up an interesting question. How did you choose which songs to put on this project, and were there some that you decided to leave off?
Well, again, it was kind of decided by the songs that we were doing for the audio book. When Tom Utes began to put the little instrumental things behind the songs that I was talking about in the audio book, that kind of set the stage for the ones that we would record. There was no hard and fast way. We didn't just sit down and say, let's pick this one, and this one. It just kind of happened that way. And when we got through, we had 10 songs and 10 instrumentals. So I guess I probably could have done a few more. Maybe we'll do volume two if this one does well.
I think that's a great idea. Absolutely. Folks, BillAnderson.com is the website. The Hits Reimagined is the name of the album. 10 songs that are sung by Bill and 10 instrumentals on this project of those same songs, and you can get that at his website. Bill, I know your last album, Anderson, you had out on vinyl. Have you got plans to put this one on vinyl as well?
Well, I don't know. I find that a lot of people, Scott, really like the vinyl. You know, it's so old, it's new again.
Yeah.
People are discovering the warmth of the vinyl sound. You know, I never know exactly. We didn't know we were going to do it on the Anderson record, and we just got a lot of requests for it, and we did it. I don't know. I cannot answer for sure whether we'll do vinyl on this one or not. It's probably a little too early to decide.
Yeah, well, I hope so. I love vinyl myself, and I also like having the cover, you know, where you can sit there and look at the pictures and read the liner notes and everything. And as you get a little bit older, those CDs are a little harder to read, you know.
You've noticed that, huh?
I've noticed that, yeah.
So have I.
Speaking of covers, tell me about the cover. You've got some interesting statues in the background behind your picture there.
There was an old, for want of a better word, a merry-go-round, a carousel that was down at the lower end of Broadway in downtown Nashville, right down where the Cumberland River flows through downtown and kind of divides Nashville. For years, there was an old carousel down there that somebody had built and designed and had created all of these different characters instead of the usual horses and things that you'd see on a merry-go-round. They had various figures of people who were famous in Nashville. They had Porto Wagner and Little Jimmy Dickens, and I don't remember who else, Dolly Parton, I'm sure. And a bunch of those were characters on this carousel, and it was quite a tourist attraction. They finally had to move it. I don't know exactly why they had to move it, but they did. And it has been reassembled and is now in the new Tennessee State Museum. But during the time that we were shooting the cover for this album, these figures were in the warehouse out on the west side of town, and the photographer who was shooting some pictures for me knew about it, and he got in touch with the people, and we got to go out to the warehouse and pull some of these old figures out of storage and just kind of arranged them in the background, and I sat in front of them, and he snapped the pictures, and it's a very unique looking album cover, and you can look there, and I think you can see Davy Crockett and a bunch of famous Tennessee people there. Very unusual cover and an interesting experience to get to pose with all of those figures when we were shooting the cover.
Oh yeah, I thought it was a neat cover. You know, it's kind of retro looking, but yet it's current too, which is kind of the way that this album is. You know, you've got a lot of old songs and you got new songs, and they're all done in a spectacular new way. So, you know, what a perfect cover.
With the actual CD itself, when you open it up, you can see a couple of the shots. You can see Chet Atkins kind of riding his guitar and waving his hat up in the air, and then you can see some other people, different characters that were on the carousel, and there's a little story there about it as well. But, you know, when you've had as many records out as I have, you look for different ways to present them, and I thought this was a very unique approach to doing the visuals for this record.
Absolutely. In the early days when they were shooting album covers, did you as an artist have say-so in what was what the graphics were going to be, or did they just kind of put it together and not tell you?
They put it together, and they sent you a copy, and you opened it up, and that's when you saw it. I had a cover one time. I had an album out called Bright Lights and Country Music. This was about 1965, and I had gone out to Centennial Park in Nashville, which is where the Parthenon is, and some various landmarks around our city, and they had taken my picture in front of some rose bushes and some flowers, and I had on a yellow rhinestone suit that Nudie had made for me that I wore on the stage and television and all, and it was so colorful because all of these red and green and white flowers and all were in the background, and I thought, that's going to make a great cover. Well, when the album cover came out, they cut the flowers out and put the skyline of Nashville on me. And I didn't even know it was going to look like that until I saw it. Of course, it fit the Bright Lights and Country Music theme a little bit better. But you never knew back in those days what they were going to do with the graphics, and you were kind of at their mercy.
That's funny. I love it. That's great. Hey, on another quick subject, Jeannie Seely has got a brand new album coming out, and you have recorded a beautiful duet with her of When Two Worlds Collide. I did not know until I got this album that you co-wrote this with Roger Miller.
Yeah, one of my few co-written songs from early in my career. Roger and I wrote that one back in the early 60s, and of course he recorded it, and it's been recorded many times since. Jeannie had the idea of making it into a duet, and she asked me to do it with her, and I was honored. Jeannie's a dear friend and a wonderful singer, and this is a great album. She's really kind of outdone herself on this project, and I'm just proud to be a part of it.
Well, we're glad to see you guys singing together. That's fantastic. And there's also a video that was released kind of in tribute to the healthcare workers of a song that you wrote called Happiness.
This was an overseas thing in England. A song called Happiness was one of my biggest hits, or is one of my best-known songs over in the UK, from an artist, a pop artist named Kim Dodd, who passed away a couple of years ago. And they dug out my song Happiness, and in England the healthcare workers, it's called the National Health Service, and they took my song, and instead of singing Happiness, Happiness, they sang NHS, NHS, as a tribute to these workers when the coronavirus pandemic first came out. I was very honored by that, and understand it got quite a bit of airplay and quite a bit of recognition over in Great Britain.
Oh, that's really great. And you've got an upcoming exhibit at the Country Music Hall of Fame, too.
Well, it was supposed to be in November of this year, but of course the Hall of Fame has been closed and everything has kind of come to a stop. Right now, I think they're planning on doing this exhibit, opening it in November of 2021, and hopefully it won't have to get push back beyond that, because I'm kind of looking forward to that. 2021 is going to be a big year for me because it'll mark my 60th anniversary as a member of the Grand Ole Opry, as well as having the exhibit at the Hall of Fame. I'm excited about both of those.
Well, it's well deserved, Bill, and all the awards and accolades you've received over the years are well deserved, because you have been such an important part to country music, and my shows would be an awful lot shorter if I didn't have Bill Anderson songs to play.
Well, you're very kind, Scott. I appreciate you playing them. Every time you play one, it's an honor, and know that wherever I am, I'm smiling and I'm appreciating it.
Well, we certainly appreciate you, and I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for taking time to be on my show. And folks, please get Bill's new album. It's called The Hits Reimagined, BillAnderson.com. We are going to play a whole bunch of these beautiful songs for you, and I hope you'll go to the website and pick these up. And Bill's signing them for everybody so you can get an autographed copy, too. So, Bill, thank you so very much for being on My Kind of Country.
Scott, good talking to you again. Thank you for all your kind words, and much good luck to you and to all of the folks listening.
All right. Thank you so much, Bill. Here's some beautiful music from Bill's new album as we continue with My Kind of Country.
I love bright lights and country music. Well, I won't stay home and cry tonight like all the nights before. I've just learned that I don't really need you anymore. I found a little place downtown where guys like me can go, and they've got bright lights and country music. Bright lights and country music, a bottle and a glass. Soon I'll be forgetting that there ever was a past. And when everybody asks me what helped me forget so fast, I'll say bright lights and country music. A table by the bandstand, a bottle filled with wine. Honky-tonks were made for men with women on their mind. Nothing else can take away this loneliness of mine, quite like bright lights and country music. Bright lights and country music, a bottle and a glass. Soon I'll be forgetting that there ever was a past. And when everybody asks me what helped me forget so fast, I'll say bright lights and country music. 'Cause I love those bright lights and country music. I reached out my arms and I touched you with soft words. I whispered your name. I held your love on the tips of my fingers, but that was as close as I came. My eyes had a vision of sweet lips yielding beneath my command. I held your love on the tips of, but I let it slip right through my hands. I let you slip right through my hands. Somebody took you when I wasn't looking, and I should have known from the start. It's a long, long way from the tips of my fingers to the love hidden deep in your heart. To the love hidden deep in your heart. Thank you. I held your love on the tips of my fingers, but I let it slip right through my hands. I let you slip right through my hands. I let you slip right through my hands. I let you slip right through my hands.
Just give it away. She said, give it away. And that big four-poster king-size bed where so much love was made, just give it away. She said, give it away. Just give it away. There ain't nothing in this house worth fighting over. And we're both tired of fighting anyway, so just give it away. So So I tried to move on, but every woman that I held just reminded me of that day. When the front door swung wide open and she flung her diamond ring, said, give it away,
give it away,
just give it away,
give it away.
And I said, now honey, don't you even want your half of everything? She said, give it away,
give it away,
just give it away, just give it away. There ain't nothing in this house worth fighting over, and we're both tired of fighting anyway, so just give it away. Here where she left me, along with all the other things she don't care about anymore, like the picture from our honeymoon that night in Frisco Bay. She said, give it away, but I can't give it away. And that big four poster king size bed where all our love was made, she said, give it away, but I can't give it away. I've got a furnished house, a diamond ring, and a lonely broken heart full of love, and I can't even give it away. Still, though you broke my heart, still, we're far apart, I love you still. Still, after all this time, still, you're still on my. Just about everything since you went away. Everything that is, except the memories you left me. And that's one thing that no one can mar. I don't know who you're with. I don't even know where you've gone. My only hope is that someday you might hear this song, and you'll know that I wrote it especially for you. I love you wherever you are. Still, after all this time, still, you're still on my like an eternal fire. For every day it burns hotter, and every day it burns higher. And I haven't been able to put out one little flicker, not even with all of these tears. My friends all think I'm crazy, and maybe I am. But I'll carry this torch just as long as I can. For someday you might just decide to come home. And I want you to know, I'm still here. Still, though you broke my heart,
still, though we're far apart, I love you.